Amanda, Kelly, and Digger need to locate a stainless steel pot built two decades ago by moonshine legend Popcorn Sutton.
When was the last time you saw this still?
He's been dead several years now, and it's been several birthdays since I've been over there. Yeah, I hope that his nephew still got it.
Is that him right there?
I believe it is.
I'll keep his attention. Y'all load it up in the truck.
All I can hope for is he hadn't run this old still off a bank somewhere and run over to the tractor.
Well, you know, Bud, you remember me?
Remember you a little bit.
Me and your Uncle Harold used to run around a lot together. I'm Digger.
Okay, yeah.
I ain't seen you since you was a teenager.
What are you into?
Well, I was gonna go up here and talk to you about something that I sold your Uncle Leroy years ago, and it's a big old stainless steel pot. You know what I'm talking about?
Well, I'm not really for sure if it's still here or not. I mean, I'm thinking it might be. If you want to, we'll go look. I know.
Let's go look at it.
Pretty close to where it should be.
We're getting off to a good start here. I guess I've got a face you can't forget, maybe. Well, I hadn't seen the kid since he was probably early 20s. His nickname's Lugnut, and that's because he likes working on old vehicles.
Yeah, there's a little small mash barrel right there.
Before he bought that big pot, he used to run a little pot.
Yep.
You know, the last time I saw it, it was a pumping that liquor out, and old Leroy, he was sitting on a milk crate beside of it, watching it catch them gallon jugs.
There's some corn in there.
And there'd been some corn liquor run there.
Boy, I tell you, he made a lot of money. It really helped the family out feeding them back in the day.
There ain't no telling what kind of treasures is in these buildings.
I'd just about bet there's a snake in there somewhere.
Maybe there's some money in them barrels.
Well, you feel free to go in there and look around. I ain't gonna fight no snake for the chance of a quarter.
I remember it being here at one time.
That might be where it's at.
Another mash barrel and a few buckets.
I'm really hoping this isn't a lost cause. I mean, fingers crossed that this pot is still around, but it's been like 20 years.
Don't think it's in that.
That's the smallest room I've ever seen in an old shed.
Yeah.
That nailed shut.
Yeah.
That ain't gonna open for sure, is it?
Well, I think I may see a peach of it there. Yep, that's it. Just the way it was 25 years ago.
It ain't changed much over the years.
Oh, shoot. Okay, that is enormous.
Ain't she pretty?
You know, I hadn't seen this still in better than 25 years. Of course, that's the beauty of stainless. It don't rust, it don't fall apart. It might get dirty, but you can clean it up. Now all we gotta do is come to an agreement on how much he wants for this rascal.
Now, back in the day, Leroy gave me $500 for it, and I'd be willing to give that back again.
Well, it's a good hire loom. I mean, it been here for Shields family for over 25 years.
Yep.
It's not for sale. But I'll be happy to lend it to you as long as you want. Get a little liquor here and there. When you're done with it, holler back.
Shake your hand before you change your mind.
That'll work.
You'll have plenty of liquor, son, I assure you.
Uncle Leroy would be proud. He'd know this thing's fired back up.
I promise you, we ain't gonna disappoint him.
You know, we all made a lot of liquor on this rascal back in the day, and I'm pretty stoked about firing this old girl up again.
Now comes the fun part. Amanda, carry that rascal out there to the truck if you don't care. I'll go let the tailgate down.
Done for.
Lay it in there gently.
The next thing we got to do is get a good location nailed down for our steel site.
How close are we?
That'll do then. We'll make it work.
Let it scoot to you. There we go.
Perfect. In order to clean up the spear, I want to do two runs. I want to do a stripping run and then a spirit run. Stripping run is where you're extracting a lot of the volume of the water and all of the impurities. What comes out the other end may not be really high proof or really clean quality. The stripping run is also a tool for us to eliminate some of that stale flavor. And then a spirit run is where we're actually going to turn it into something really good.
You know, I didn't bring a label.
Close one eye and you can usually see. Kelly and I are very different. We have completely different skill sets, I think. But for the most part, we complement each other well. He's actually really easy to work with.
This thing will cook our beer off. It'll get rid of all of the bad things we don't want.
We're making Uncle Leroy proud.
I hope we're making Uncle Digger proud. barring any bad luck, this is gonna be our home for the summer. So we're gonna have our stainless steel pot. We're gonna go ahead and set us up another 200 gallon copper pot. And hopefully we've got room, maybe we might set up another pot or two. I know typically you wouldn't wanna use a thump keg to do beer, but I've got a little thump keg that fits the cap already, so we can just raise it up. And I mean, a thump keg will help with the proof a little bit coming out.
Yeah, well, and the thumper can act kind of like a slop box for us, because I know when we put the beer in there, it's gonna foam a little bit. Yeah. So my plan is to add a little bit of oil in the pot to try to prevent the foaming.
I thought we were getting rid of oil.
Well, we are. We're getting rid of the hops oils.
Okay.
But like any kind of lipid, we can use corn oil, grapeseed oil.
Use motor oil?
I wouldn't. The plan is we're gonna have like tandem stills. We're gonna have a stainless steel pot for our stripping runs and a good copper pot to do our final runs in. So Kelly has a really nice 200 gallon copper pot that we can use. It's beautiful. She's the pretty pot.
Set that up out of the way for now. We're gonna set it up so we can run either direction with this thing. So it'll just be moving the thump keg from one place to the other, and we can put it right through the same worm. Right,
oh,
even
yeah.
Over the top.
That'll sit in there good.
Oh yeah, perfectly.
I think it's pretty ingenious. We got the central worm, portable tank.
Yep.
Dueling pots.
Yep. I hope I didn't slosh too much out on the way up here.
You better not have. It was a lot of work getting it in that barrel. Today we're gonna make a stripping run, but we gotta haul this beer up to the still site. It's sloshing everywhere up this mountain.
My God, it still stinks, Amanda. I thought that'd get away from it while it aired out overnight.
Brings me back to my bartending days. It smells like an old bar drain.
Well, what do you think? Let's get this stuff pumped over and
yeah.
Get us a fire lid under it.
I just wanna get this flavor out of this beer. If you give me something that tastes okay, I can make it taste great. Can I make something that tastes terrible taste better? I guess we'll find out. She's pumping. We got a few hundred gallons of beer right now, and the plan is to strip it. And hopefully in the stripping run, we can get rid of some of this terrible smell and flavor.
Well, let's stick this burner in there and see if we can't light a fire under this thing since we've got her filled up.
Get it lit. Thanks to Digger, he managed to find us the perfect still. It's stainless steel, it's huge, and it's a Popcorn Sutton still.
You ready? Light her up, let her get burning good.
And now I get to step in front of it and light that flame.
Lay it in there.
Woo! Oh, burn some hairs off there. That was exciting. Before we put that cap on, I did bring some oil with us, grapeseed oil. I know the beer is still gonna foam a little bit, so the best thing we can do is add an anti-foaming agent. That's any kind of an oil. That is gonna sit on the surface of the pot. Oil just literally, it breaks the surface tension in it. Like, do you ever boil pasta and it foams up sometimes?
I don't like pasta.
If you put a wooden spoon on a bowl of pasta while it's boiling, it'll break the pot from boiling over.
You know, the good thing about Amanda, she's doing stuff that I'd have never thought about. I mean, I'm just gonna go along with it because she's done this before.
It's getting pretty warm.
Actually, it is getting warm up there. It's baked the bread.
It's a slow process, but fingers crossed that we can make this work.
I think we're getting closer.
I know.
We're gonna have liquor before very long.
It's running right now.
Oh, shoot.
It's dripping.
It is, isn't it?
Good job. Beautiful.
You know, going into this, we know that the better that we get it to taste coming out of the stripping run, the better chance we have of cleaning it completely up in a spirit run.
Well, Kelly, it's flowing pretty good. We got 5 gallons. So I'm really hoping we've improved this flavor a little bit, but this is the moment of truth. All right, Kelly.
What have we got?
I'll let you taste it first. I'm gonna start having nightmares about beer after all this, I'll tell you what.
You don't want none of that to touch your tongue, ever.
You know I gotta try it too, right? Gotta see what we're working with.